let's plunge straight into the unfamiliar country that is question one. One of the biggest problems faced by explorers, as you can probably imagine, is that of language. Alan and Bill, I would like you two to imagine that you are two of the Pilgrim Fathers who arrived on the Mayflower in the coast of the United States or America.
Right.
And I would like Rich and Sean to imagine that you are Native Americans who meet them. How? You can use sign language if you like. Would you communicate?
I would immediately read from the Book of Common Prayer. Hail, savage.
Hi, how are you?
What's that, Toby Jug?
Yes.
Where's the pub?
Foaming pint of beer.
Hummity, hoppatimity, itimity, never mind the buzzcocks. Jonathan Creek. Come on. I can't believe my eyes.
Not just never mind the buzzcocks, other things as well. In stand up. Piano. Playing in hotels.
You think you're the first explorers here, don't you? Where do you think these eyeglasses came from?
The extraordinary thing is, between them, Rich and Bill are absolutely right. The first thing said by one of the Native Americans who met the Plymouth Brethren was, could I have some beer? In English. He asked for beer in English.
He met Indian, did?
Yes. He spoke fluent English. He'd crossed the Atlantic six times. This was in 1620. America had been visited by others. The Pilgrim Fathers were not the first people to land in America by any means.
It's a trick question, wasn't it?
Yeah, his name was Squanto, the best known of them.
Yes.
But this particular one was called Somerset, and he spoke very good English.
Somerset.
What did he say then?
He said,
get off my land! Oh, my God.
Some cider!
You bloody Pilgrim Fathers, get off my land!
He learned his English from fishermen and from his friend Squanto. And from the archers, probably, as well.
Sure. Are you buzzcocks? That's what he said.